Squeaks and I have been learning all about Antarctica, a place so cold it feels like winter all year round. Oh, Squeaks says his favorite thing is the penguins. We learned all about them too, like how they look funny on land, but are super graceful in the water. Oh, yeah. You're right that you won't see many other animals on land in Antarctica. But looking below the surface of the Southern Ocean and the Antarctic seas, you'll find a very different story. Even though it's freezing cold, penguins and many other animals swim in the seas surrounding Antarctica. These are called marine animals. Marine is a word that tells us these animals live in the ocean. I would have a really hard time swimming there too. It's so cold! But for these marine animals, the super cold ocean is a great habitat. A habitat is a place that provides everything an animal needs to live, like food and a place to stay. These animals are part of a huge food web in the ocean, with different animals that live and swim near each other and even eat each other. It's pretty amazing, and each creature in this food web has a special way to survive the cold. How is that possible? Well, let's take a look at this leopard seal. Do you see anything that would help them keep warm? Ooh, good observation, Squeaks! It can be hard to tell sometimes because the seal is wet, but they have a warm fur coat. But that fur on its own wouldn't be enough to keep them warm. So seals actually have another secret layer that helps them stay warm while they're swimming in cold water. How do they do it? Under their skin, seals have a special layer of fat called blubber. This blubber doesn't get cold easily and acts like a super thick coat between the cold seawater and the warmth inside the seal's body. Most marine creatures like seals, whales, and orcas, and penguins have some amount of blubber, especially around Antarctica. And being big and blubbery helps to keep the cold outside of their bodies instead of having it sink in and freeze their insides. Ooh, good question. Not every animal has blubber. So how else could swimming creatures stay warm? Well, not every animal needs to stay really warm to survive. Squeaks, what's another animal that you might think of when exploring underwater habitats? Fish! You're right! They are so neat! Different species or types of fish can live in marine habitats all around the world, including in freezing cold Antarctic waters. Fish are part of this food web too. They're food for penguins, seals, and orcas, so it's super important that there are fish that can survive in the cold. Take a look at the group of fish called notothenioids. These fish don't have blubber, so the insides of their bodies get cold enough that it could freeze another animal. Oh, no worries, buddy! Notothenioids have a special adaptation that stops them from freezing. Their blood has special substances that lower the temperature at which liquid water freezes into a solid. We call substances like that antifreeze. Even though notothenioids live where it's cold enough to freeze water, or a person, the antifreeze in their blood keeps the fish swimming along without becoming fish-sickles. It would be really interesting to have anti-freezing blood. For many animals like notothenioids, their chilly home is just fine by them. There are sometimes other problems because of the cold, though. Well, let's go from looking at big animals to teeny tiny animals. A favorite food of many Antarctic sea animals are little critters called krill. Krill are related to crabs, lobsters, and shrimp. Antarctic krill's insides don't need to stay as warm as a bird's or a mammal's, so they don't have fur, feathers, or even blubber to keep themselves warm. They can even grow faster in colder waters. Krill eat phytoplankton, which are itty-bitty things similar to plants that grow in the water. Some phytoplankton grow well in the cold, but when winter comes to Antarctica, the seas get too cold, and there aren't as many phytoplankton for krill to eat. Well, the krill survive without food by shrinking. Adult Antarctic krill can molt or shed parts of their bodies. They can even use some of their old body parts, kind of like food, so they can shrink down and stay alive. When the summer comes and the waters become slightly less cold, the phytoplankton come back and the krill grow big again. Oh, it does sound like it might be hard to grow and shrink so often. But without these super survivor krill, so many animals would go hungry. Krill are eaten by fish, penguins, seals, whales, and even more marine mammals. Each of these animals in this freezing food web has their own unique adaptations to help them deal with problems that come from living in extreme cold. Whether we're looking at the blubber of seals, the amazing antifreeze blood of fish, or the shrinking skills of krill, each animal survives in its own way. And many of these animals rely on each other. The bigger animals need there to be plenty of smaller animals there to survive. Without the tiny krill, there wouldn't be big whales. Yeah, isn't it neat how everything's connected? Even in one of the coldest places on Earth, there's so much to learn about animals and how they live, eat, and survive. Say, why don't we find some videos about krill and learn about eating in the cold while we eat something cold? I have some ice cream in the freezer for us. We're off to learn more about ocean life around Antarctica. If you'd like to learn more about amazing extreme animals with me, Squeaks, and all of our other friends, be sure to hit the subscribe button and we'll see you next time here at the fort.